Well, history could be made today. At NASA, they hope to launch the most powerful rocket yet. It's called Artemis 1, and this is a live view of the rocket on the launch pad at the Kennedy Space Center in Florida. Let's go to Fox 2's Chris Renier. He joins us live in West St. Louis at the planetarium with a preview of this big day. Good morning, Chris.
John, good morning to you. A big day indeed. You know, this return to the moon and beyond for NASA has lots of people excited. The launch window for Artemis 1 St. Louis time is between 7:33 this morning and 9:33 this morning. And you can bet lots of people will be closely watching to see if Artemis 1 can indeed blast off into space. Artemis 1 stands taller than the Statue of Liberty at 232 feet, and it's really the new era of lunar exploration. This test flight will have no people on board, but it will send the capsule on a 42-day mission around the moon. After a decade in the making, NASA says Artemis 1 is a necessary first step in a series of missions to the moon and beyond. Since there are no astronauts on board for this first flight, special mannequins with sensors will keep track of vibrations and G-force upon the launch. They will also track the amount of radiation that astronauts will be exposed to in deep space. The largest heat shield ever built of this kind will be tested as Orion will eventually re-enter the Earth's atmosphere at some 25,000 miles per hour. It is going to need to withstand temperatures as hot as 5,000 degrees Fahrenheit. NASA officials spoke about the importance of this mission.
Sets us up for the future missions, which will have crew on board. So Artemis 2, hopefully launching in 2 years or so, plus or minus, that will have 4 astronauts on board going around the moon. And then after that, Artemis 3 and future missions will actually land people on the moon.
If today's launch has to be scrapped for some reason, there are backup opportunities both this Friday and on Labor Day. For now, live in West St. Louis, Chris Renier, Fox News.